to Saints of the Day on Lumen Christi TV. Today, the church remembers Saint Maria Goretti. Maria Goretti was born into a poor and devout family near Rome in the year 1890. She was the third of seven children, and she had no chance to go to school. She never learned to read or write. She was one of the larger and somewhat backward members of her class. But notwithstanding, Maria had a deep spirit of prayer and worked so hard to help her parents. Her father died when she was 9 years old, and Maria had to help out with caring for her younger siblings and the housework while her mother ran the farm. She received First Communion at the age of 11. But as a matter of fact, she was soon backward and only managed to become better by the day to even pass the catechism. 6 months later, at the age of 12, she was stabbed to death as she fought after an attack of a rapist. Alexandru stabbed Maria to death because she would not give in to his demands for sex. She had to be taken to the hospital, and her last hours were marked by the usual simple compassion of the good and her concern about her mother, where she would sleep. She was preoccupied by forgiveness of her murderer. She had been so afraid of him, but did not say anything lest she caused more trouble to the family. And her devout welcoming of the Viaticum, her last Holy Communion, were all what mattered to her just shortly before she died. Maria died about 24 hours after the attack, and she died forgiving and praying for her assailant, Alexander, who later repented and lived a holy life. In fact, he became a Capuchin lay brother and gave evidence at the canonical inquiry about Blessed Maria. Pope Pius XII canonized her in the year 1950, and it was an event attended by her aged mother as well as her murderer, Alexander. Maria Goretti is the patron saint of Catholic youth, girls, and teenagers. What is Maria's message for our world today? Our reflection continues after the break.
In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save.
Back. Dear friends, Maria pulled one of the largest crowds ever assembled for a canonization. 250,000 people present symbolized the reaction of millions touched by the simple story of Maria Goretti. The life of Maria brings to mind the message of personal dignity or private integrity at a simple human level. It is that we're able to hold on to our convictions and our self-worth even in our privacy. This speaks volume towards the women folk who always fall prey to the whims and caprices of those who take undue advantage of women by way of sexual exploitation and many other means. At that tender age of 12, Maria was mature. She had fear of God and such conviction for her faith that she would not yield to any compromise. Devotion to this young martyr grew eventually with time. Miracles were worked, and in less than half a century she was canonized. At her beatification in the year 1947, her aged and partly paralyzed mother, who was then 82 years of age, two sisters of hers and a brother appeared with Pope Pius XII on the balcony of St. Peter's. And 3 years later, at her canonization, there was a 66-year-old Alessandro Serenelli knelt among the 250,000 people and was full of tears of joy. It was an event that attracted such enormous Holy Year crowds that even St. Peter's Basilica, huge as it is, could not contain them, and the ceremony, for the first time in history, was held in the open square in front. Maria obviously came from a poor home and was not learned. She had trouble with memorizing and even reciting the catechism, but she had no trouble with her faith. She was so disciplined and convinced about her belief. God's will was holiness, decency, respect for one's body, absolute obedience, and total trust, and she lived that to the full. In a complex world, her faith was simple. She believed it is a privilege to be loved by God and to only love Him in return at any cost. Let us pray. God, author of innocence and lover of chastity, you conferred on Saint Maria Goretti, your handmaid, the grace of martyrdom at a youthful age. Through her intercession, grant us constancy in your commandments, you who gave the crown to a virgin who fought for you. Amen. Thanks for staying with us. It's been Saints of the Day on Lumen Christi TV.